dirt a little bit. But folks, for your patience, lead way. All ashore, please watch yourself, watch your head. Thank y'all so much. Great evening. God bless you.
Well, howdy, everybody. Hey, let's try this. Merry Christmas. Hey, that's a whole lot much more better. Hey, this is Ernest Tiki, your conductor on the sing-along steam train. And folks, wait a second. Shirley and Steve, everybody say Merry Christmas, guys. Hey, I did say this was a sing-along steam train, so folks, here we go. Six and a half million likes later, what do you think about the job we did? Hey, thank you. Yep, it's starting to look like Christmas. That can only mean Santa Claus is coming to town.
You better watch out. You better not slide. You better not slide. I'm telling you
why. And here we go, folks. Need your help. What is the name of that red-nosed reindeer?
Yeah.
know, friends, when I think about Christmas, I think back when I was a boy. Every year we go visit my grandparents for Christmas dinner. They live way out in the country like we are now. We walk in the house, Grandma be finishing up that Christmas dinner on that old wood stove of hers. Friends, let me tell you, the smell of that turkey, country ham, mashed potatoes, and gravy, and all those Christmas goodies would be all through the house. Hey, if you left her table hungry, it was your own fault. After we finish eating, we'd all gather in the living room. My grandpa would take a seat in his favorite rocking chair. That big old Christmas tree over in the corner, all set up and decorated, and all of those gifts wrapped and stacked all around and underneath the tree, just ready to be opened. One thing I remember about my grandpa, he was a very wise man. He would not let us open up one single Christmas gift, not a one. Not until we all gathered as a family, he told us the story. The true story of the true meaning of Christmas. Folks, almost 60 years later, at this time of year, if I sit real quiet, close my eyes, think back, and I listen, well, I can hear my grandpa say,
Merry Christmas, kids. Oh, it's so good to see you. Grandma and I have been expecting you. Grandma's up in the cabin right now, and she's baking sugar cookies. Grandpa likes to eat sugar cookies. Actually, Grandpa took a sugar cookie. That's why Grandpa's sitting out here. But I love this time of the year. It's a time when friends and family get to come for a visit. And everybody's happier and friendlier. Oh, I wish it was that way all the time. And it could be. A long time ago, there lived a man who taught us how to have that attitude all the time. He was a special man. He lived a special life and he died a special death. Many wondrous things happened to that man. One of the most wondrous was his birth. And I'd love to tell you the story about the night that Jesus was born. Same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night, when suddenly the angel of the Lord came upon them, and they were sore afraid. But the angel said, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God, saying glory to God in the highest, peace, goodwill toward men. And when the angels had left them, they went and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Later, wise men from the east came saying, Where is he who has been born King of the Jews? We have seen his star in the east, and we have come to worship him. And lo, the star they had seen in the east went before them, until it came to rest over the place where the child was born. And when they saw the child, they knelt down and worshipped him and offered gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Yes, they offered many great gifts to the child. But were the ones that had received the greatest gift, the gift of life everlasting. Wasn't that a wonderful story? Well, folks, I know you've got to get back into town. Lots of things happening, and I don't want you to miss out on anything. But I want to thank you for spending part of your evening out here with your old grandpa. I'm glad you made it home for Christmas. And I hope that everybody can. Merry Christmas, kids.
Merry Christmas, Grandpa. Thank you so much for that wonderful Christmas gift.
You're welcome. Bye, kids. Merry Christmas.
Jolly Parade will be at 6 o'clock. That's about 15 minutes from now. When we get back to the depot, if you just walk straight out the gate up the Valley Road, you get a good seat or a good viewing point to watch the parade. Hope you take advantage of it. Right now, let's continue with the sing along. We've got a little bit of Mr. Gene Autry for you.
Here comes Santa Claus, so jump in bed and
I ask that you please remain seated until I give you the all ashore. This old train tends to roll back and jerk just a little bit. So for your safety, folks, please wait. Please wait. Please wait.
What are you waiting?
Wait. All ashore, watch your step, watch your head. Thanks for riding. God bless you. Have a wonderful evening.
Thank you.